Did you know that there's an easier way to Live2D? In this video, we're going to go over some useful tips and settings for optimizing your Live2D workflow. Let's get started! Tip number 1. Keyboard shortcuts. One of the best ways to speed up your workflow is by setting up keyboard shortcuts. These will save you tons of time, especially when you're working on complex projects that require a lot of different actions. You can set them up under the Preferences menu, and you can basically set up shortcuts for almost everything. If you have an extra keypad, or in my case, a controller, you can also use those to set up shortcuts. So customize shortcuts for reflecting, pasting forms, or any other functions that you use often. For me, I have shortcuts for creating new warp deformers, using the temporary deformer function, and opening the physics settings. You can export these settings to save them and import them on another device. So this is what my shortcuts look like for reference, as these are the main tools that I use, and I use keys on the left side of the keyboard because I'm right-handed and my right hand is on the tablet and mouse, and I make sure that any key combinations that I have are close together so that it doesn't hurt to use them. And while it might be basic, don't forget that you do still have standard shortcuts like Ctrl-Z to undo, Ctrl-Z to copy, and Ctrl-V to paste. Tip number 2. Creating a rigging template. Did you know that you can create your own rigging template by exporting parameter and physics settings from an already finished model? If you always set up your head angles, your hair sway, or your toggles in a similar way for most models, then you can save them into a physics and parameter export file. And then when you start a new model, you can just import those files and it'll automatically set up the parameters and physics groups for you. You can always delete the parts that you don't need later, but having the base already structured saves a lot of time. For example, mine has angle augmentations and some common toggles and physics setup. This automatically sets up your parameters with the correct physics group, and it's very convenient. To do this, the first thing we're going to do is create a rigging template. Either create or select the model that has most of the physics and parameters that you use. Click Modeling, both setting of model parameters, and click Export. And then open the physics settings, select physics, and then select export physics settings. And now whenever you start a new model, you can just go to Modeling, bulk setting of model parameters, import the one that you just exported before, and then go to physics settings, physics, and then import physics settings. And it'll automatically create the physics groups and connect the parameters, and you can just work as normal. Tip number 3. Live2D on multiple devices. So here's something that I didn't know. If you've got the pro license of Live2D Cubism, you can actually activate it on 2 devices. So for me personally, I like to rig like heavier models and also export them on my desktop, but I use my laptop most of the time when I'm rigging on my bed when my back hurts or like when I'm outside. Just activate your license key on both of your devices and you're good to go. Just make sure to import your keyboard shortcuts on your second device as well. Tip number 3. Auto backups and folder settings. So Live2D already does automatic backups for you, but did you know that you can adjust the backup folder settings? Go to Environment Settings, File, and under Auto Backup, you can change how often Live2D creates backups and the size of your backup folder. I work very slowly, so I set mine to create a backup every 10 minutes, because if it creates a backup every 2 minutes or so, nothing's gonna change. And I work on a ton of models at a time, so I set the storage space super high. See what works best for you, because I promise that one day you're going to be so glad that the backups were there. Tip number 4. Edit textures without re-importing. Wanna change how your model looks even after you've already rigged it? You actually don't have to re-import the PSD and re-export your model in order to fix things like colors or minor design details. When you export your model in Cubism, it uses texture atlases, which are just PNG files with all of the model's parts laid out on them. You can open these PNGs in your art software and draw directly onto the textures. For example, if you wanted to change your hair color, you can open the textures PNG and just draw directly on top of it. You can also do this for minor fixes like, oops, I forgot to give her red highlights again, and now it's fixed. Just be careful not to move or resize any parts or you'll mess up the mesh mapping. You do have to be fairly familiar with your own texture atlases, but it's still useful to know. Tip number 6. Quick dropdown search. If you're dealing with long dropdowns, like when you're assigning parts to physics or switching parameters, typing the first few characters in the dropdown is going to move that list to whatever you typed. So here's how I name things to make use of this feature. For parts I reflect, like ears, I tag them as angled bracket ear L and angled bracket ear R. That way, when I'm setting up the physics, I can just type that specific angle bracket and then E in the dropdown to quickly find all of the left ear parameters. It's a small trick, but it makes a huge difference when we're working with tons and tons of parameters. And it also works in the physics settings screen. Tip number 7, clean up unused PSD parts. So cleaning up unused PSD layers is something that everyone forgets to do, or at least I forget to do it, but it's really important. Whenever you import a PSD, Cubism is going to import each and every single layer, even the hidden ones. So if you have placeholder parts, sketches, or layers that were in your design phase that are still probably in the model file, they're still going to be in the model, even if you're not using them. To delete the layers that aren't being used in the model, open your project panel, click your PSD, right-click it, and select Delete Unused Layers. Make sure to only do this after your model is completely finished. Tip number 8, troubleshooting PSD import issues. If your PSD file refuses to import into Cubism, don't panic, it's probably one of a few common issues. Here's a checklist. Number 1, make sure that any through layers or through folders are changed to normal. This is my most common problem. 2, make sure that there are no folders that are deeper than 5 layers. 3, make sure that the color mode is RGB and then make sure the colored channel is 8 bits channel. Even after checking all of that, sometimes a PSD just won't cooperate. When that happens, I open a new blank PSD with the exact same pixel size, and I manually copy and paste all of the layers from the old PSD into the new one. And that almost always fixes it. Also, make sure that none of the layer names are coded in any way, because that was something that happened to me once and it really drove me crazy trying to fix this PSD, and it turns out that it was just having trouble importing because one of the layer names was like slash angled bracket slash layer group or something. I deleted that layer and it worked perfectly fine.
Tip number 9, using spreadsheets.
Whenever you see something like this, something like a spreadsheet-like layout in Cubism, like in the physics settings or in the parameter list, you can actually use it like one. For example, in the physics settings, you can hold Ctrl and select multiple cells and simultaneously change the numbers. Or you can change the numbers for the entire column. And you can do the same thing in the parameter settings as well.
Tip number 10, movement path preview.
Did you try to use extended interpolation to try and smooth out some rotations, but it still looks off? Try this. Turn on onion skin, and then go to modeling, onion skin setting, and check orbit of selected vertex. When you turn that on, whenever you select the vertex on the warp deformer, you'll be able to see how it moves. So you'll be able to see if there's anything strange with the movement and adjust your interpolation accordingly.
Tip number 11, using temporary deformers.
The temporary deformer is one of the most underrated tools in Cubism. What they basically let you do is they let you apply transformations without actually having to create the deformer. This is super useful when you want to adjust something without messing up or having to think about your parent-child hierarchy. So for example, if you want to make a head tilt or an eye rotation that you think would be easier to make with a rotation deformer, you can do it with a temporary deformer instead of having to make a rotation deformer. So it's easily accessible with this button here, and you can change the kind of temporary deformer tool that you're using. So personally, I mostly use temporary rotation deformers, and I have a hotkey to use them. And the changes are going to stay even after you leave the temporary deformation screen. So it's just like rigging normally, go to the keyframe that you want to change, you click here, and then you select whatever temporary deformer tool you want to use. For example, I'm just using a rotation deformer, and then you make your change, and then you save it.
Tip number 12, preview your physics.
Do you want to see how your model moves with actual face tracking before you export your completed model? Did you know that you can now connect VTube Studio to Live2D Cubism to preview how the physics are going to behave in real time with the face tracking? First, in Live2D, go to File, External Application Integration Settings, and press this to turn it on. Then in VGIF Studio, load any model, just as a placeholder, and scroll down to the Live2D Cubism API. In General Config, press Connect. And back in Live2D, make sure to give permission in the External Application Integration settings. And now in the physics settings, whenever you move your face, you'll be able to see your hair sway, the clothing, and all of that react right inside of Cubism. This is super helpful for testing and fine-tuning your physics, like your hair bounds or your breathing, just before you finish exporting the model.
Tip number 13, set your model center.
When you export your final model, don't forget to set your model center. This controls where your model rotates and zooms in VGIF Studio and any other embedded use case. I usually set my center to the face, which for me is Y0.1 or Y0.2, because I feel like for VTuber models especially, that's a very natural space to zoom in. If it's somewhere like in the middle of the model, it might zoom in on the legs or on the skirt, which is fine, but it feels a bit clunky to use. So setting it up properly is a very small, very quick thing, but it makes things feel a lot smoother when they're actually using the model. So that's it for today's tips and tricks. I hope you found some of these useful to your Live2D experience. Feel free to share any tips that you might have in the comments below so that everyone else can know about them. Thank you for watching! この番組はご覧のスポンサーの提供でお送りしました。